Welcome back to our video series on working with Scribus. In this video, I will show you how to work with images in Scribus. So we have our standard document template here. I am going to insert an image frame. I'll go to the image, insert image frame, and I'll drag a frame here, and you see it's an image. We know, as we talked about in the working with frames lecture, that this is a symbolizes a image frame. And the easiest way to insert an image into this image frame is to right click and just click on the get image. Then we can travel to the place where we want to find our image. And once we get there, we can just click on that, and then we will insert the image. Now, you'll notice that the image is not perfectly sized to fit the image block. So there's a couple of ways we can fix that. One is to right-click, and we go to the context menu, and I can adjust the frame to image. If I click on that, you see what happens, the frame gets larger. Now in this case, my image is too large, so enlarging the frame is not a good idea because it falls outside the document. So I just want to undo that. So I just want to show you how that works. And what I want to do instead is adjust image to frame, which is most likely what you'll be doing because you probably want your image to fit inside the frame that you've built into your document. So click on that, and now my entire image shows up. And you see that the adjust frame to image to frame retained the proportion. So the picture is actually smaller than the actual frame, and we will show you in a minute how we can work with that to change that if we want to. Of course, the easiest thing, if we don't care about the actual size, is just to shrink the frame so that it fits the image. Or the other thing we could do is work with the properties menu, which, as I said, I will go over in a few minutes. Now, another way to insert image, which is a little bit more difficult to remember, is to go to File, go Import, and then Get Image. And then it's the same thing as if I just right-click. So it depends on the way your mind works, but usually for me, right-clicking is more logical. All right, now that we have inserted our image, let's go through the rest of the things that are on the context menu. I've talked about adjust frame already. Update image. Now, update image is used if I make a change to the source, and rather than deleting and re-adding the image, I can just click on update image, and it will automatically reload from the source. So if I've made any changes, that's how you would fix them. All right, after update image, we have image effects, which we can see here some of the available options. We can blur an image, we can play with the brightness or contrast, we can turn it to grayscale, we can add some other shapes and so on there. So I'm not going to go into detail there, but if you want to experiment with that, then feel free to do so. That's on the context menu. Edit image. As you can see here from this warning, I don't have Scribus connected to GIMP. So what this is trying to say is that if I wanted to edit my image, what would actually happen is it would go out to GIMP and you would do your editing in GIMP, save it to the source, and then do an update here as well. So it's kind of like the external story edit on their text image. It's an editing tool, which I haven't set up yet to have Scribus talk to GIMP. All right, the other items in the context menu we've either covered before or we're going to cover at some point. So there's nothing really to go through here. We can then move on to properties. And what's important with properties is you can see that we can do some image manipulation. We can change the baseline XY coordinates. So if I move them, you see how the image moves, or if I move the X coordinates, you see Y coordinates, sorry, moves up and down, X coordinates moves left to right. I can also change the width of the frame. And as you can see, because I've got the proportion clicked here and keep the ratio aspect, I am not filling the frame. The picture is staying the same size as before. If I unclick that and I then change the width, you can see then the picture starts changing as well. But we don't usually we don't want to play with that. So usually, when we have a picture, we set to fit into a specific type of frame, a size. So normally, the only thing we're going to do with an image here is to right click and then click on the adjust image to frame. And that's all we usually have to do as far as positioning is concerned. All right, we may want to change the base point, for example, if we're doing something like a rotation, but otherwise, it's not going to make much of a difference when it comes to this properties menu. And that's all there really is to working with images in Scribus.